two viewers. The following video is on internet, its connection and its protocols. But before starting explanation on this, I will inform you that you can contact me for online tuition classes from class 1st to 10th any subject and for any of the computer programming language. My email ID for contact is in the description of this video and in my channel about section as well. Internet. It is the necessity of today's generation. It is combination of two terms. International plus network means internet. Since 1950, internet is continuously serving the needs of its users. Developed by Winton Cerf, who is also known as the father of internet, in order to share information across multiple computers globally or locally, internet plays a major role and the information exchange can be in the form of text, video, audio. This inflow and outflow of data or information follow all standardized communication protocols with the purpose to ensure security. Can also be called as network of networks or World Wide Web. History of Internet. Base of the Internet is ARPANET, which is Advanced Research Project Agency Network, which is the first packet switching network. After the development of ARPANET, NSFNet was came into force for engineering research projects. Combinational approach of both ARPANET and NSFNet formed the internet. Now, there are certain terms related with internet. Let's understand each one of them. World Wide Web, a reserved location of all public websites which are accessible all over the world. Web page, main element of website, similarly like book, is made up of pages. Website is made up of web pages. All web pages are hyperlinked documents containing images, text and other multimedia elements connected together to form a website. HTML is the main ingredient to form web pages. Website, it is the collection of web pages. All these web pages are hyperlinked with each other to form a website. It is a structure made up of HTML as standard language for website creation. Each website has a unique address on the internet, which distinguishes it from the rest of the other websites. The first page of any website is known as the home page. Server, a program which responds to users' internet research request. It generally operates on powerful and robust operating systems like Unix, Linux. Apache, the most popular server developed by Apache Software Foundation. Client, here the term client means the person or the user who is availing the services of internet by different means, either by doing online shopping or by visiting websites to explore. Web browser, the application program through which the client interacts with the web server. It uses various searching algorithms to find the result of the client search queries instantly within seconds. Two types of web browsers are there. Text-based web browsers which return the result in text mode only. Example, Linux, and graphical web browsers. Example, Google Chrome, Safari, and many more. Search engine, a website, similarly like a browser, return the results of user search queries. The layout of the website is simple, as it only has a search bar in it, in which the user or the client types its questions to find the response. Example, Google, Yahoo. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. It is the unique address of the particular web page or website, which is registered on the internet to get specific place on the server. The first URL was created by Tim Berners-Lee and his team. URL is divided into three parts: scheme, host, and path. Scheme option inform about the protocol to be followed while fetching the result, like HTTP and HTTPS. Host includes server name, example www, and domain name, example websitename.com. Inside the domain folder, save on server which file to exist. That that path is given by the third part of URL. Domain, it refers to a unique name that identifies a particular website and computer connected to the internet. Period or dot operator is used to separate the two parts of the domain name. First part signifies the name of the website, and second part is the domain type or extension, or we can say abbreviation. Usually the domain type is 3-letter, but if it is of 2-letter, then it must be a country name like .com, .edu, .in. ICANN, which stands for Internet Corporation for Assigned Names and Numbers, is the organization that provides domain names on World Wide Web. Domain name system is the one which converts the domain name into IP address. ISP stands for Internet Service Provider. This is an organization which is responsible for providing internet services to its customers through devices like modems, routers, and charge from them that much amount of money depending on their internet bandwidth requirements, like Airtel, Vodafone, and many more. Download. It refers to the transfer of data from the server computer to the client's computer with the help of internet availability. User can save images, files, PDF files, Word files, and other format documents in his or her computer system with just one single click on the download button. Upload. On the contrary, upload is just the reverse of the download. It refers to the transfer of data from the client's or the user's computer to the server computer with the help of internet availability. Intranet, a small private network which is set up by an organization for its own internal use. It maintains a security aspect in the information exchange among the employees. Extranet, similar to intranet, this network is also used by the members of an organization, but it allows some shared content accessed outside the organization boundaries, like with vendors and clients. Internet backbone. It is a cable line which connects dissimilar networks to the main server. ISDN stands for Integrated Services Digital Network. This is purpose digital telephone service used to transmit voice, data, image and video over a single telephone line. It supports high-speed digital transmission. It is expensive to set up. Hyperlink, simply called as a link, which is used to connect web pages in a website. Whenever clicked, it redirects the user to another web page on the different tab or open the new web page on the same tab. Highlighted with blue color and underlined is it identification. Hypertext. The text which is made as a link is hypertext. Any text which needs further explanation is generally made as hypertext. Even images can also be connected with redirected links. IP address. Any host or client computer connected to the internet carry a unique address which makes simpler for the server to send the data packets to the correct device. It is of 4 bytes separated with periods or dots in between. IPv4 is of 32 bits and the current version IPv6 is of 128 bits in size. Newsgroups. Digital newspaper is something known as newsgroup. There are also interactions and discussions are done through chat session on the specific topic. Blogs. Any opinion on a particular topic. Daily experiences refers to as blogs or web blogs, as these blogs are written on a website which provide two-way interaction. People feel free to express in various modes, either by text, videos, or images, and these writings are known as posts. These posts can be on personal experiences, business purposes, or general props. These contain small information sent by the server to be get stored in the user's web browsers when user visits a website, so that again requesting that same website instead of connecting. modulator and demodulator helps in internet connection as it converts signal from digital to analog and from analog to digital. Three types of modems are there: dial-up, DSL, and cable modem. Protocol refers to those rules which two interconnecting devices must follow while communicating over the internet to maintain the standard and security of interaction. There are multiple connections through which you can connect to the internet, like dial-up, DSL, cable modem, broadband, Wi-Fi, WiMAX, VLAN. Let's discuss all of these. Dial-up, the oldest form of internet connection, which is relatively slow in speed. It uses the telephone line connection to connect to the internet and perform data transfer. Usually unstable in operation and not expensive even. The main drawback of dial-up is that while talking on the phone using the same telephone line which is used for internet connection, then at the same time internet service is not possible to be used. DSL stands for Digital Subscriber Line, a broadband internet connection which uses copper telephone line for high-speed internet connectivity. Expensive but not be able to provide long-distance connectivity. The major advantage of using it is that it is faster than dial-up connection, and also user can simultaneously use phone line for calling as well as for internet surfing. Cable modem. It provides users or the customers a high bandwidth internet service as compared to dial-up and DSL connections. It uses coaxial cable for connectivity and transfer of signals in between computer and ISP. Expensive and supports data transmission at a speed of about 1.5 Mbps. Broadband, it comes under the category of high-speed internet connection, which is unaffected by weather conditions as well. Modem, router are the network devices which are required for it to be operational. Broadband provides both wired and wireless connectivity. Bad in broadband refers bandwidth, which is the amount of data transfer, and it provides broad bandwidth. Wi-Fi stands for wireless fidelity. It is the wireless internet connectivity which requires router, modem, and internet service provider connection for its connectivity. It uses radio frequencies for wireless transfer of data with all the necessary security mechanisms of encryption. Mostly used nowadays as it is reliable and not that much expensive to set up and use. WiMAX stands for Worldwide Interoperability for Microwave Access. It is the fastest wireless broadband connection. Faster than Wi-Fi, WiMAX is even operational in those areas where it is difficult to set up the wired internet connection. Leased line, it is also known as direct internet connection. It is the fastest wired broadband connection. Through the use of fiber optics cable connection, it provides consistent amount of bandwidth with faster upload and download speeds. It is the most expensive internet connection. The most important internet protocols are TCP/IP, FTP, NMTP, SMTP, HTTP, Telnet, SSH, SCP, and WAP. Let's understand all these. TCP/IP stands for Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. It is the first and foremost the most important protocol out of all the other protocols that must be already built in by the developers and programmers along with the operating system. Since the time internet was built and solving the problems of long-distance communication and connectivity, TCP is also there as a helping hand, or can be called as the major pillar of internet connectivity formation. The role of TCP is to divide the message which is to be sent into packets at the source, and while these packets are transmitted and reached at the destination, it gets again reassembled into the main message. The role of IP is to check whether these packets are traveling at the correct path over the network to reach the correct destination. TCP/IP provides a reliable connection-oriented service throughout the network. FTP stands for File Transfer Protocol. Traditionally, before the use of internet, we share files and folders in between two computers located at the same place, connected with the same local network with systems network option. But if sharing is to be done in between systems that are geographically located far away and using different network connections, then comes in the role of FTP, which requires internet for its usage. So while performing downloading and uploading of files in between client and server, FTP protocol is used along with the TCP/IP for secure sharing of files. NNTP stands for Network News Transfer Protocol. This protocol works while the user connects with the Usenet servers regarding news groups, articles, postings. SMTP stands for Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. It is a standard reliable protocol for exchanging email messages between multiple users, works in collaboration with TCP/IP protocol, and follow all the security guidelines while transfer of mail messages. Also supports notification facility as well, as so that user must be aware of all the incoming mails. In case mail message not delivered due to network issue or due to incorrect mail address, SMTP protocol send messages not sent email to the user. HTTP stands for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The role of this protocol is to establish fetching of data from web server to the web browser when the request has been made by the user. It is a stateless protocol, as its every command works independently without interpreting with each other. This is the default protocol used in every URL. Tim Berners-Lee created HTTP protocol. Telnet stands for Telecommunication Network. It is the oldest style of virtual connection between two computer systems, useful when the user from his or her own system situated at different locations wants to access or take control of the computer system, or we can say the remote system located at some other another location and in working mode or operational through some another user, so as to make connectivity of handling the system from such a far distance. Telnet protocol, along with the helping hand of TCP/IP protocol, worked together by using command line software. A session is established between both the systems with the username and password facility, but the security mechanism used were not that much advanced. SSH stands for Secured Shell. It is the modern alternative of Telnet protocol. It is the safest way of remote computer connectivity, as the drawbacks or the loopholes left in the security of Telnet protocol is completely overcome in the SSH protocol. Unlike Telnet protocol, SSH provides GUI for remote connectivity between computer systems. SCP stands for Secured Copy Protocol. Like FTP protocol handles uploading and downloading of files through internet, similarly, SCP protocol manages transfer of files in between remotely connected devices. This exchange of files is done in completely encrypted way. WAP stands for Wireless Application Protocol. Today's smartphones manage their connectivity with this WAP protocol protection. Internet applications. The areas where internet is mostly used. Email stands for Electronic Mail. It is a digital or electronic medium of sending and receiving messages. For security purposes, while transfer of messages, email service follow certain protocols. Nowadays, it is very common and used everywhere by everyone, as it is a paperless method of sending messages, images, letters within only a few seconds. To access its service, user have to generate its email address, which is a combination of username, @ symbol and domain name like abc@gmail.com. Video conferencing, a digital way of face-to-face conversation between multiple people located far away from each other with inbuilt audio support as well as with other various options. A very convenient, reliable and easy-to-use long-distance communication mechanism, mostly used for formal business meetings, requires high-speed internet support like Skype. E-banking stands for electronic banking, online way of performing banking operations like account creation, withdrawal of money and other certain transactions. Formally, can also be called as internet banking or virtual banking. Through the use of electronic gadgets like smartphone, laptops, along with debit and credit cards, anyone can do its banking transaction anywhere with just some clicks on that specific bank website or bank application. E-commerce stands for electronic commerce, which is nothing but doing business online. Websites are the main entity for fully nourishing the e-commerce people's business. They sell their products online on the internet and make big profits. E-shopping stands for electronic shopping. As people nowadays are not getting time out of their jobs, household tasks, so they find online shopping an easy and reliable way of doing shopping without wasting time going to market. In this way, they save their time and energy as the purchased product is delivered at their doorstep. People even get attracted to a lots of discount they get on these e-shopping sites like on Flipkart, Amazon and many more. Online chatting. Traditionally, we use SMS service which gets charged every time we send messages. But as the time changes, the need to exchange information given rise to internet chatting, a free messaging system, which is now the most popular and everyone's necessity as it supports both text and multimedia based chatting options. Multiple apps have been developed and are continuously developing to make people connected all over the world, like WhatsApp and many. E-reservations stands for electronic reservations. Technological advancements has also changed the way we travel and the way we used to make reservations before traveling. Online ticket booking system is very convenient and fast, safest way to book or check availability of ticket or to cancel booked ticket for every tourism area, whether it is travel tickets, hotel room booking, events booking, movie ticket booking, example, Book My Show, Make My Trip and many more. E-learning stands for electronic learning. Spreading of information is not limited to only classroom walls. It is now expanding more and more through the use of internet. To grasp knowledge and become literate and educate is now the right of every single individual. So in order to make this happen, online learning is most important. Mobile banking, a very popular mechanism used to perform banking transactions using mobile technology with some of the most secure and trusted apps. 24 hours, 7 days availability of banking services provide convenient environment to function, like Paytm and many more. Social networking, freedom of expressing emotions, thoughts, ideologies are now possible with social media. People from all over the world are virtually connected with each other to share their views on a particular topic. This new kind of online connectivity has revolutionized the way internet works. Lots of social networking sites and apps are now in market, which are frequently used by people all over the world, like Facebook, Instagram, and many more. Thanks for watching, and for more videos, subscribe my channel. Viewers, if you want to join my computer tuition classes, kindly contact me on my mail ID provided in my channel.